What's up everyone, and welcome to my Lady Inerva Darkvein video for the How to Pass series. And I gotta say that Inerva is probably my most favorite boss fight of the current raid tier, since it's very nice as enhancement shaman, it has a lot of cleave potential and it's just really fun to play. If you haven't seen it, I actually got rank 1 on our first kill which I uploaded to YouTube, and after that some people actually topped me in terms of DPS on this fight. And in this kill that I recorded, or that I streamed basically a few days ago, I actually took back the rank 1 with like almost 6.8k DPS. So I thought it would fit pretty well for the series, and that's why we're gonna take a look at this right now. So I just say we started right up here. I think I was just talking about legendaries there in the stream. So on pull pretty much we use everything. We use Bloodlust, all of our cooldowns, everything. And just blast the boss as hard as we can. That's pretty much just the beginning of the fight. And the thing about this fight is you always want to time your Doom Winds with the adds that are spawning. You never want to use your Doom Winds when no adds are up, basically, except for on pull. There's one exception to this rule, which actually happens in this kill. Since we actually skipped the first adds, so there were no adds coming in the beginning, the first set of adds. So I basically just used my second Doom Winds on the boss as well, just like single target. I definitely missed out on a lot of cleave damage there, but that's just how it is sometimes. You can also get unlucky, lucky, however you want to see it, if you basically immune all of the adds. Since we got immunity classes assigned to use immunities right when the adds are about to spawn. So sometimes you just get no adds if you're really lucky, or in terms of cleave damage, unlucky, I guess. So right here I use my second Doom Winds. I actually, if you didn't catch it right there, I actually used a Wind Fury totem a little bit too early, and then I had to recast it afterwards to trigger Doom Winds, since I kinda messed up a little bit there. So definitely a mistake that I can improve to not be as greedy and just wait like half a second to actually proc Doom Winds. So definitely didn't play perfect here, but that's just how it is sometimes. So yeah, we didn't get the set of adds here, so I'm just using it for single target damage. And yeah, that's just what we're doing. I actually get sins here, but as you can see, my Doom Winds window was over, so I'm pretty much fine with playing mechanics here. So I actually have to play the orbs here, which you should probably know how to do, since yeah, you know the boss, I assume, like the mechanics. So I pretty much see the hunters running over here to the two ones. I'm also linked with a paladin, so I know that he's not as mobile as me, basically. So I just take the far one here with my ghost wolf and sprint. I run over here, step a bit to the left and the right until we get it. And then, as you can see, I use my Door of Shadows to get back. Since it's not that long of a walk, but Door of Shadows is always faster than just running, so I just port back. I could have charged as well, which would have been really fast as well, but I chose to Door of Shadows there. And I'm right back into the fight. I didn't lose a lot of damage, I'm still 6 on the meter there, so we're still good. And we're back on the boss before the set of adds spawn, which will still take a few seconds. And yeah, right here I have my Chain Harvest ready, as you can see in my weak auras here, I have it ready. But you don't want to use Chain Harvest on this fight for single target damage. You always want to use it for cleave damage, basically. So a really good showing as well here. I get another mechanic to play, which is really nice, since actually in this kill I can show you most of the mechanics that you have to play. So right here I get an add, and we just clumped them together basically, so you're just not hit by the other circles basically. So I position myself right here, obviously in range of the boss, so I can still keep uptime, so I can still do damage. And the other melee can just stay right outside of this, out of the circle, and can also still damage the boss. So that's what I'm doing right here. I'm also trying to stand in the AMZ right here. And also, on top of that, right before I spawn the add, I will use my Astral Shift right here to mitigate some damage. And then we get the adds. I'm assigned to do the interrupt on the cross add, the second interrupt. So definitely always want to focus target that add. And now you can see how I'm bursting. I got 4 targets here. And pretty much on the adds, you always want to use your Doom Winds. And you want to try to hit as many targets as possible with your Sunder, and afterwards with your Crash Lightning. Like, you want to position your character and your camera angle, so you can get the most cleave damage out of it. Also, while the ads are up, and later when only the Spectre and Inerva Darkvane are alive, you always want to use Chain Lightning instead of Lightning Bolt to reset your Crash Lightning cooldown, so you can fish for procs all the time. So right here I focus target this one, I use my Wolves into Doomwinds, and then I pretty much just Sunder here. And then right here you can see my positioning. I just used my Chain Harvest here for big cleave, and you can see my positioning. I'm looking this way, so my Crash Lightning pretty much hits all of these three targets, and I think it may even hit the fourth one here if I'm close enough. And that way I pretty much just get the cleave of Crash Lightning and of Storm Strike on all of the targets that are alive here. And you can also see me using chain lightning, as I said, to reset the cooldown all the time. And that's pretty much what we're doing right here. And now we're just cleaving. Obviously we want to hit the boss instead of the Spectre, since we don't want to kill our cleave target here. It's not really necessary. Later we call a swap on the Spectre on the next set of ads, and then you obviously have to kill the Spectre, but for now it's just cleaving the boss. So right here, we move the boss and I place another Wind Fury Totem, which is really important. Since, as you can see, I want to have all of the members in my group to have Wind Fury pretty much all of the fight. That's a very important job as an Enhancement Shaman as well. It's not about your own damage all the time, it's also about the other people's damage and about the raid damage in general. So now we're in this corner and we're pretty much just single targeting the boss, as always. And there's the next set of ads. We will have Doomwinds up in about 12 seconds again, and we have our Sunder ready, and everything is fine. I position myself right here where the rings overlap, outside of the rings obviously. And right here I have 7 Maelstrom weapon stacks, and I keep them until the ads spawn. And as soon as the ads spawn, I will use a Chain Lightning to instantly reset the cooldown of my Crash Lightning and buff my next Crash Lightning, so I can instantly Crash Lightning all of the ads and start cleaving on them basically. So here the ads spawn, I use a chain lightning into crash lightning, and yeah, obviously I focus target the ad again and make sure to do my interrupt here. And you can see my positioning again. I'm always trying to position in a way where I can hit all of the targets with my Crash Lightning basically. That's why you can always see me stand in between the ads, basically. And yeah, we're pumping pretty hard on this boss right here. And another thing is, you can see right here, I refresh my Flame Shock on Inerva, basically. And then I just do some damage. And now my Shock cooldown is ready again. And I don't Frost Shock Inerva, but I spread my Flame Shock to the Spectre. And you can do this. I don't really think that you should Flame Shock the small ads all that often, since they tend to not live for 18 seconds. But on the Spectre, it's definitely fine to spread your Flame Shocks here to get some more damage out of it. And then it's just back to Inerva and cleave from Inerva onto the Spectre, basically. Right here, since we want to move the boss, the swap gets called to the Spectre, so we just instantly kill it here. And back to Inerva. I always use my sprint for moving the boss to keep as much uptime as possible. Since keeping uptime for your melee attacks and your other abilities to fish for procs basically is really important as enhancement. So right here we get another set of ads. I have one of the ads again. And as you can see again, I position outside of the ring of the other ad. I position in the AMC and I position to where I can still do damage on Inerva. And yeah, that's where we're spawning the ads right here. On this pull, I chose to use all of my cooldowns, Wolves, Ascendants, and Doomwinds, even though my Battle Potion, as you can see to the right here, isn't ready yet. Since the boss was really low and I wasn't really sure if it was worth delaying them, so I just thought now that we have a triple set of ads, since sometimes, as I said, some of the ads get immune, since now we have a triple set of ads, I think it's worth to use my cooldowns here, even if I don't have the battle potion, just to get as much cleave damage in as possible, basically. So I spawn the ads here, I take mine into focus, and then I use my ascendants here, I start cleaving, get Doomwinds down, I also do my interrupt here, I get a big sundering, and then I just spam my wind strikes here during the ascendants. The small adds are gone, and now it's basically just a Spectre again, and Inerva Darkvane. And she's getting pretty low, we're at 20% already. My Chain Harvest is now ready here, and I use it on two targets. Two targets is fine, you just don't want to do it on pure single target, basically. And again, I spread my Flame Shock onto the Spectre, which is really important. Luckily, I don't get any mechanics here. So I played the orbs in the beginning of the fight. Luckily, I didn't get them here. If you get them during your cooldowns or during an ad spawn, that's very unfortunate for your damage, but that's just how it is sometimes. Like, you can't really do anything against that. So right here, you can see we get another set of ads. We get two ads here. So this one on the boss is reflected. If a warrior reflects the ad spawn back onto the boss, you can stand in that circle. You don't have to dodge this. You just have to be careful with the ads that actually spawn off of players here. That those circles you want to avoid. But you can freely stand in the circle that's reflected back onto Inerva Darkvane, basically. Which is what I'm doing right here, and all the other melee as well, obviously. So we got the last two ads here. And again, I get Doomwinds ready. And there's a perfect line where I could have used my Sunder. Again, big mistake from me here. The enemies are pretty much perfectly lined up. And as you can see, I use Wind Fury again too early. The second time I do the same mistake in the same boss fight. Like, it's pretty hectic here, so it can happen from time to time, but it's really bad if it happens. Also, by the way, I just noticed, I didn't mention it before, I used my Earth Elemental for damage as well here, just to get to get the maximum health buff, so I'm at over 50k HP for pretty much anything that is going on in this fight. Since sometimes on the last percentage, if we really greed it, sometimes we have to open one of these four here and take a lot of raid damage, so the extra max HP definitely helps with that, and to just get the additional damage from the Earth Elemental. But back to what I was saying, I placed Wind Fury too early, I used my trinket here, and I thought I proc Doomwinds, but I didn't, and that's why I used my Sundering here without Doomwinds, which is really bad for my damage, but as I said, I'm not perfect, I do a lot of mistakes as well still, so there's still room for improvement, pretty much for everyone, so yeah, that's just one mistake I can work on improving. Luckily I notice it though, and I use my Doom Wounds afterwards, and start cleaving here. And I try to hit all three enemies right here, while just cleaving Chain Lightning into Crash Lightning, into Storm Strike, into Chain Lightning, into Crash Lightning, just as you do it. And then it's just the Spectre and Darkvane left. And yeah, I didn't get Sins here, luckily. And we're pretty much just finishing off the boss. So yeah, 2%, 1%. And it's pretty much dead. And I'm at 6.8k DPS, which is really nice. And you actually could see, I think if I remember correctly, I actually said on stream, I said that could have been rank 1. And yeah, we checked it right afterwards, and we saw that it actually was rank 1. So yeah, it's a really nice boss fight. I really like playing Inerva. It's a really fun boss fight, and there's a lot of stuff that you can optimize as enhancement. So I definitely hope that this video helped you guys in terms of improving your damage. You could hopefully learn something, and yeah, you should definitely go for it. Try to improve your DPS. Obviously, try to play the mechanics as good as you can as well. Don't just ignore the mechanics. That's not what I'm aiming for with this video series. It's just about helping you guys get into the direction where you can improve your overall performance. And yeah, with that being said, I thank you guys for watching. Take care, stay healthy, and I hope to see you guys in the next video. Bye bye.